La próxima semana, el Parlamento Europeo podría aprobar una nueva resolución condenando las más recientes acciones represivas del régimen Ortega Murillo. Desde 2018, los eurodiputados han aprobado cuatro resoluciones pronunciándose en favor de las víctimas de la represión y rechazando las acciones del actual gobierno. Entrevistamos a la miembro del Parlamento Europeo, Tilly Metz, luxemburguesa, presidenta de la Delegación para las Relaciones con Centroamérica, acerca de esta oleada represiva y la detención de 21 rehenes políticos en las últimas semanas en Nicaragua, y esto fue lo que nos dijo.
Gracias, diputada Metz, por esta entrevista. Usted, junto con otros 9 miembros del Parlamento Europeo, enviaron una carta a la embajadora de Nicaragua ante la Unión Europea expresándole su preocupación por el escalamiento de la represión contra líderes de la oposición, empresarios y aspirantes presidenciales. ¿Cómo describiría usted lo que está sucediendo en Nicaragua y por qué es de especial preocupación para usted?
I think what we're hearing coming from Nicaragua since April 2018, the crisis where we had a lot of people injured, a lot of deaths, and now it's getting coming, the elections coming in November, it's getting really worse and worse. We are Ortega is drifting more and more away from a democratic functioning. Around 20 opposition leaders are imprisoned. We have persecution of journalists. We have civil society living under pressure, not able to live freely. So it's quite clear right now that the upcoming election in November are not going to be fair, neither free. So that's very, very worrying for us. So we had already a resolution on Nicaragua. But I hope we probably in the next plenary, so next week, we're going to have another resolution with debate on Nicaragua, really to have clear words condemning what's going on in Nicaragua.
¿Y qué nos puede decir sobre esta resolución que posiblemente se apruebe la otra semana?
On the resolution, I must say right now, I cannot say a lot because we are not working on it yet. It has still to be decided. You know, it's always a short-term decision. And then we are going to work on a resolution with a clear language condemning what's going on. And on the other side, I think nevertheless, we keep to have an open floor still for any communication, especially, of course, we are still communicating with the civil society. We have a very strong EU delegation, ambassador, EU ambassador in Nicaragua, and also the other ambassadors of the European Union are doing really a great work to be present, to keep up the diplomatic efforts, to calling also for diplomacy and calling for dialogue. Promoting also human rights. So they are doing a very important work there. Regarding now the upcoming resolution, we need to look what we can do further. We have already targeted sanctions, and I think we should go on with this targeted sanction to widen it. But again, it is very important for us that we don't harm the civil society, that we don't harm the Nicaraguan population by the sanctions, because they're suffering already a lot.
Como usted lo ha dicho, la Unión Europea ya ha sancionado a varios funcionarios leales al presidente Ortega y a la vicepresidenta Murillo para presionar al gobierno en la búsqueda del fin de la crisis. Pero ¿qué otras medidas están contemplando para abordar la situación de Nicaragua?
We need to see what we can do also regarding, I think we should also work closer together with other countries. The US government announced sanctions on 4 senior members of Ortega's government, including his daughter. Argentina and Mexico also recalled their ambassador to discuss the situation. I think also we need to have a coordinated approach, the European Union together with other countries. And on the other hand, I think also we're speaking a lot, you know, at the European level these months and weeks about due diligence, you know, that the companies working with countries outside the EU, that we should respect this due diligence. This means respecting human rights, respecting also environmental rights. And I think it's important we really also do that regarding our trade negotiations and trade agreement, that we respect, come closer to this, what we really expect to happen, this due diligence obligation also for European companies.
Otros miembros del Parlamento Europeo han pedido la suspensión de Nicaragua del acuerdo de asociación con la Unión Europea. ¿Es eso una posibilidad? ¿Cómo valora usted ese tipo de medidas?
Yeah, you must know this association agreement is not completely implemented right now. So it's a little bit, there is still one European country, Belgium, has not signed up to it. And on the other hand, the trade pillar is functioning. That's why the trade is functioning anyway. And the cooperation and the political pillar of this association agreement is anyway right now not really implemented. But I think that might have really consequences also then for the Nicaraguan population. So we have really to think, it's important to have targeted sanctions, but on the other hand, as I said before, we keep on to hold on the bridges for diplomacy and for communication, and that's very important. So I'm quite skeptical regarding now pushing Nicaragua out of this association agreement, because I don't see that a general solution is the right solution. We have to put pressure on the Nicaraguan government, that's for sure. We have to show solidarity and act in favor of the civil society and bring them all our support in order to progress to freedom, to progress to more democracy, fair and free elections, and so on, in order to have this reform of the election and so on. So there is a lot to do, but I don't think that now cutting all the bridges of communication and diplomacy generally, I don't know if that is the right solution. Just before our meeting now, I had a meeting with women from Nicaragua whose husband just were taken away in a very brutal way. They don't have any lawyer. They don't know where their husband or partner is. They're just, it must really be horrible. So I really feel a lot of pain for all these families and for all these people in Nicaragua who saw their family member just taken away brutally by police and not knowing where they are, what's happening, how their health situation is. So I have a lot of feelings of solidarity and a strong, also I would like to say them, you are not alone. So the European Union has to take its responsibilities and not just by nice words, solidarity words, but also by action.
Usted también ha dicho que el diálogo es una herramienta muy importante para abordar la situación en Nicaragua. ¿Ustedes han buscado algún tipo de diálogo? ¿Buscarían como Parlamento Europeo establecer un diálogo con Nicaragua? Recientemente la ministra española de Relaciones Exteriores habló sobre cómo habían intentado dialogar con el gobierno de Nicaragua, pero fallaron en el intento, y el gobierno nicaragüense de inmediato respondió con una carta bastante hostil. ¿Usted cree que se debe hacer un nuevo intento y cómo?
As I said before, I have a lot of trust in the EEAS, which is the External Action Service of the European Union and of our EU delegations who are on the ground looking for solution, trying to connect in order to keep up this communication. Now, regarding also, for example, the upcoming elections in November, we know that there is not going to be an official, and they don't want us to be clear an observation mission of the election, neither from the EP, from the European Parliament, neither from the EEAS. But nevertheless, I think it's very important we show presence and we keep on trying to connect, but for clear for the moment. We wanted also to do a mission in Nicaragua, also already last year. Of course, it was rejected. And I think if we ask again, now for the moment, missions are still not possible, but probably because of the COVID situation, but probably up to autumn, the missions are going to be possible. We're going to ask again, but for sure they're not going to want to see us. That's for clear. That's the answer probably we will get. So it's very difficult. But on the other hand, on the international level, Ortega and his government is more and more isolating himself. So at one moment, he cannot stand that anymore. And as I said, it's not only the European Union taking measures, and also I think then the European companies and so on and so forth. It's also now the US government. They are very interested. What's happening? The vice president already went to Guatemala, so they are very interested also because of the issue of migration, but they also want to know, as we do, the sources of migration. And so I think he's going to be attacked by different countries, and different pressure are going to come. So I'm still optimistic that something is then moving at one point.
¿Y cuáles cree que deben ser las condiciones mínimas para establecer ese diálogo con el gobierno de Nicaragua?
But first of all, for us, it's very important that all these prisoners get released. These political prisoners. I'm speaking now of the opposition leaders, about 20, but we know that there are much more political prisoners. I don't know, I've heard about 130, 140 political prisoners, or people who, as I said before, where the family member just was taken away, even don't know where it is. So that is very important. And then installing, really proceeding to a reform of the election procedure, guaranteeing freedom of movement, guaranteeing freedom of expression. So that would be the steps in that direction, would be very, very important in order to have a dialogue regarding the whole electoral reform, the steps that needs to be taken in order to guarantee civil and political rights, restructuring the Supreme Electoral Council, and so on and so forth. So there's a lot that needs to do. We would be there in order to support if there would be any demand coming in that direction. But for the moment, I have more the feeling Ortega does not really care about. But at one moment, as I say, if the pressure comes from different side, and even getting larger, and even also the companies taking their responsibilities at one moment, And Nicaraguan people are very brave people and very strong.
¿Considera usted que Nicaragua se encamina hacia la misma situación de Venezuela, un país cuya elección la Unión Europea tuvo que reconocer como ilegítima?
The risk is very clear. As the things are going, as I said already, I know that these elections, if it goes on like this, it's for sure not fair and free elections. So there is certainly the clear risk that the European Parliament, but I'm not allowed now to speak in the name of the whole European Parliament, but that would be then, if it goes on like that would be a logical consequence for sure. If nothing changes, I mean, what is democratic in this election? I mean, If you are just repressing, putting people into prison, people living in fear in Nicaragua, that's not the election that we can recognize, that's for sure.
Como presidenta de la Delegación para la Relación con los Países de Centroamérica, ¿cómo afecta la situación de Nicaragua al resto de la región?
Of course, it has close consequences on the neighbor countries. We spoke already about migration, a lot of desperate people in Nicaragua, of course, trying to flee the situation. So it certainly has also an impact on the other countries, on the around and Central America. I mean, there are a lot of issues, and there's also elections coming up in Honduras and with other challenges, but Of course, right now the very worrying situation comes from Nicaragua, and it certainly has. We want so much to support those countries to become democratic and to strengthen the democratic institution. And it's, I must say, we are very closely connected to the people from Central America. And a lot of people, I think, like me, once you have been there, seeing the kindness and the beauties of the country, you've seen it's such a catastrophe that this country cannot live in peace and freedom and where.
Diputada, usted es miembro del grupo de los Verdes, Alianza Libre Europea, que aglutina a movimientos de centro izquierda y de izquierda y que luchan por la autodeterminación. ¿Cómo valora la justificación del gobierno de Ortega, que se considera a sí mismo de izquierda, cuando dice que lo que hace es protegerse de la interferencia de otros países, cuando estos países le señalan las violaciones de derechos humanos que ha cometido?
For me, being a left party is being close to the people, is guaranteeing social justice and so on. We are far away from all that now in Nicaragua. That is only, I see there a president who wants to be, in any case, who wants to keep the power in any case. So, I'm wondering, honestly, I'm wondering often, how could it happen, this evolution, which is now really an evolution not for the population, but definitely against the population.
¿Considera usted que la Unión Europea puede hacer más para poner fin a la crisis en Nicaragua? ¿Veremos más acciones antes de la elección en noviembre?
That's what exactly we're going to debate also regarding next week, our plenary read, and I hope we're going to have this resolution. There we are sitting also together, what we can do, working closely, as I said, also with the EEAS, working closely with the people on the ground, because it's another thing when you are here in Europe or being working on the ground and trying to find constructive solutions, because what is our center of concern is really the citizens of Nicaragua.
El periodismo independiente empodera a los nicaragüenses y enriquece el debate público. Por eso nuestra misión como periodistas es garantizar que nuestra cobertura noticiosa sea libre y gratuita para todos los lectores. Por eso te invitamos a formar parte del programa de membresía de Confidencial, para formar parte de esa comunidad que respalda nuestra misión. Podrás tener acceso a contenido adicional del que ya ves, lees y escuchas a través de nuestras plataformas, que continuarán abiertas para todas las personas. Gracias por tu apoyo a nuestro medio y por tu solidaridad con las audiencias nicaragüenses.